also already told my colleague Monique Eerde has broken her leg and ankle. So unfortunately she couldn't come. And I was asked to present this paper because I was very much involved in this project. So Monique is recovering well and gives you all her greetings. And in these 5 minutes, I want to focus on one specific subject, the creation of new knowledge. And I will touch upon four issues. First, the problem, then the tackling of the problem, then the results, and I'm ending with some suggestions. And as this paper is very short, for more background information, I refer to this volume, Knowledge for Informed Choices. You can find it at our stand, the Dutch Cultural Heritage Agency, or you can find it on the internet as a PDF. So, first, the problem. As you may know, archaeology in the Netherlands is a very hectic world of developer-led projects. Each year about 4,000 projects or investigations are carried out. Most of them are inventories to check if any values are threatened by development plans. And about 150 excavations are carried out each year. And these numbers are a bit decreasing, as you can see, due to the financial crisis. But it's quite impressive. Most of these investigations are published within the 2 years. And the reports, as you can see at the right, are available. But these piles of reports are growing and growing. And the problem was that the information from these reports is not integrated and analyzed. As you can see, the circle of archaeological heritage management from inventory, assessment, selection, preservation in situ or excavation, and then interpretations and synthesis. And the dark part, that's the problem. This cycle was jammed at the red area, the red box. There is insufficient interpretation and synthesis of developer-led research. There are no new questions that can be answered with new research. To tackle this problem and other issues, the Dutch Heritage Agency was asked to set up a program that was called Archaeology Knowledge Kit. And we wanted to focus on what are the big knowledge opportunities in these large amounts of reports. What is the information in the piles? And how can we extract this information and transform it to new knowledge? That was the main question. So we took several steps to do this. First, we checked the research questions in the national research agenda. And step two, we checked the reports. We did a survey of over 800 archaeological reports, extracting the data, not in a very detailed way, but on several subjects, and which region, what is the date, what is the site type, is it a settlement or a grave field, and so on. And the outcome of these two steps gave insight, you see it on the left, in what are the potential knowledge opportunities to answer these big national questions. And these opportunities were transformed as project assignments, as you can see in step four, and put into the market. And the last 3 years, 12 synthesizing studies, as you can see at the right here, were created by companies and by universities. And there are 12 on very different topics. For instance, it's one about occupation history of the Netherlands from the late Neolithic to Middle Bronze Age, which is an English volume. And there's one about occupation history and land use of the Holocene Valley of the Meuse. There's this one. It's a regional synthesis, and there's one about wooden objects. In all these studies, new questions are formulated that can be answered with future excavations in order to close this archaeological heritage circle as an ongoing process. And now we're evaluating this approach. Are these studies used? This new knowledge was aimed at the world of archaeologists working in the field and working as a heritage resource manager at a local government. How pleased are they with these studies? And this processing of information to new knowledge is also an ongoing process. And in the future, more of this kind of studies will be carried out, not at the level of creating 12 studies in 3 years. There's a budget from the ministry, a much smaller amount, but about one study a year. The question is, do we proceed the same way, or do we change the approach? And you can think of several options. Maybe I thought of several suggestions, and maybe you have some too. One is you could make a synthesis of the 12 syntheses. So it's really quite interesting, I think. It will lead interesting issues about, for instance, the usefulness of the archaeological reports and the scope of the new questions. Another thing is you could integrate the data from old unpublished excavations. Also information in that. Another option is you can translate the new knowledge to a much broader audience. As you can see, these local officials, the older men of a local community, they are interested in archaeology, but maybe still a bit afraid, standing over like this. So cooperation with the local government or provincial government is also a possibility to cooperate with them. These are suggestions for the future, and for now, I thank you for your attention.